A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th Jan, on the front page you have Supreme Court not to review Sabrimala case to examine larger issues. So, 9-judge bench of the Supreme Court will decide on constitutional questions raised by religious practices. So, we had seen when the Supreme Court was hearing the Sabrimala case review petition, it said it will refer this question on how far the judiciary can intervene in religious practices to a larger constitutional bench. So, 9-judge constitutional bench is looking into this matter and it will just look into this issue. Then the review petition would go before concerned Supreme Court bench. So, here you can see there are 7 issues that have been framed by the 5-judge review bench for the larger this 9-judge bench. So, they form the crux, but may be reframed for future hearing before the 9-judge bench. So, these broad issues you can see are these 7 questions raised. What should be the interplay between freedom of religion under Article 25 and 26 and right to equality under Article 14? And whether right to practice religion is a subject of is subject to public order, morality and health? What do these terms actually mean? Public order, morality and health. What do these terms mean? Because there are restrictions on every fundamental right. Of course, there are restrictions on right to practice of religion too. And third is constitutional morality the overarching morality in reference to preamble or limited to religious beliefs of faith? Then next is, should and if so, how far can a court inquire into whether a religious practice is essential to a particular faith or not? Because generally, then questions when they come before the Supreme Court, it is looked into whether the religious practice is an essential religious practice or not. And based on that, the ruling is given. Then next is, what is the meaning of the expression sections of Hindus, which appear in Article 25(2)(b) of the Constitution? And whether essential religious practices deserve constitutional protection under Article 26? And what is the extent to which courts should entertain PILs questioning religious practices filed by a third person who is not a member of that faith? So, this is actually a restriction being put, a question being raised, whether anyone can file a PIL, public interest litigation on religious practices. And this is retail inflation at 5-year high of 7.3% in December. So, food inflation is up by 14.2%. Shortage of onions has resulted in this spike in food inflation actually. And retail inflation is also at a 5-year high for the month of December. So, this is inflation based on consumer price index. Retail inflation. On page 6 you have, inscriptions confirm presence of 2 medieval monasteries at Mughal Mahal. So, this is in West Bengal in Paschim Medinipur district. So, a study of inscriptions on clay tablets recovered from recent excavation here has revealed that a Buddhist monastery of early medieval period was there. So, there were actually 2 monasteries present here. So, this is based on the study of the inscriptions. And below you have organic turmeric to weed out marijuana in Malkangiri. So, this is organic turmeric which is all set to weed out cultivation of illegal marijuana in remote areas of Odisha's Malkangiri district. So, the administration has initiated this project to dissuade the region's tribals from illegal ganja cultivation, and profitable cash crop organic turmeric is being promoted. On page 9 you have, Maharashtra Gujarat lag behind in compensation for sewer deaths. So, this is a committee which has been set up and it has seen that the compensation that is not received by those suffering in case of sewer deaths in Maharashtra and Gujarat. So, even the implementation of manual scavenging prohibition law is being reviewed and it is seen here that it is still practiced because sewer deaths still take place. Tamil Nadu has the highest proportion of those, followed by Gujarat, you can see. So, this is the number of sewer deaths between 1993 and 2019. The darker color shows more deaths. So, rather than taking such a huge time frame of more than 25 years, it's better to take the data for the last 5 years or so, so that a better understanding is there on how many sewer deaths are taking place presently, not adding up the past deaths. So, that proper action can be taken on this data. So, this is data from National Commission for Safai Karmacharis. Then below you have Supreme Court asks for response to home buyer's plea. So Supreme Court has asked the government to respond to this petition which has come before it, challenging the newly promulgated Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Ordinance of 2019, which retrospectively prohibits individual home buyers from initiating insolvency proceedings against builders. So the Section 3 of the ordinance prescribes a minimum threshold for initiating insolvency proceedings before NCLT. So it requires that NCLT need to take cognizance only if it receives an application for insolvency process jointly filed by 10% or 100 in number of the total allottees, home buyers, whichever is lesser, from the same project. On the editorial page, the first editorial is unhelpful combativeness. So this is regarding Citizenship Amendment Act. There are concerns with respect to it. Prime Minister Modi had also spoken yesterday on Front Page News. We saw he spoke on Citizenship Amendment Act. Here it says PM Modi must address the concerns about Citizenship Amendment Act instead of misinterpreting it. So it has been misinterpreted, as we saw yesterday too, that when it is said that it is not taking away citizenship but rather giving it, but it is denying citizenship on the basis of religion. Actually, it's not just about facilitating citizenship provision for minorities from the three neighboring countries, Muslim majority countries. So it's not just that you can get citizenship by naturalization in some number of years and now that has been reduced. That is not just the case, but they are illegal migrants, and illegal migrants at any point of time cannot apply for citizenship. But for them, the provision of illegal migrants has been dropped, but others would still remain illegal migrants and they cannot acquire citizenship. Means for Muslims, they cannot acquire because they will be illegal migrants. Then second editorial is vote for status quo. So this is regarding elections in Taiwan and the ruling party's win. So it is said this will make the dispute with China more difficult to resolve now, because the party which has won, it has been more open, and it has been congratulated by many countries on its win, which has not been taken down well by China. So the Taiwan dispute as such will take more time to resolve now. Then this is the lead article, Sparkling People, a Spiritless Opposition. So it is said the streets are ferment over Citizenship Act, but the political opposition is still to catch up. So people are protesting, but the opposition is not matching it up. And this is different feathers, but a political flocking together. So it says an anti-BJP stance may explain Maharashtra's coalition experiment of Shiv Sena, Congress and NCP. So all three have taken a stand against BJP on this issue, on Citizenship Amendment Act. So this is how they are binding together now. Then on the op-ed page you have, is a new India rising? So this is talking about whether the new generation is laying down its own terms for the country's future discourse. So what kind of India do we want? The youth has risen. And this is in the name of self-defense. So the US strike in Iran that killed Soleimani was in violation of UN norms prescribing such unilateral use of force. So UN norms do not approve of such unilateral use of force and conducting assassinations, but in the name of self-defense, US has assassinated military general of Iran, Qasem Soleimani. And this is, protest is the core of poetry. This is regarding Faiz Ahmad Faiz's poem, Hum Dekhenge, which is a popular Urdu nazm, which has been used by anti-CA protesters. Then on page 12 you have Nobel Laureate arrives for lecture tour. So this is Nobel Laureate Venkatraman Ramakrishna, who arrived in India on a four-city lecture tour. So he was in Lahore, Pakistan, where he delivered scientific lectures, and now he's in India. So he received the Nobel Prize in 2009 in chemistry. So he has spoken on political issues too. Like last month he has given his criticism on Citizenship Amendment Act, which discriminates against Muslim refugees in India. It does not discriminate against Muslim citizens of India, but yes, it does against Muslim refugees who are staying in India. Then below you have Apache Chinook to make Republic Day debut. So, Apache attack helicopter and Chinook heavy lift helicopters, which have been recently inducted by the Indian Air Force, will make their debut over Rajpath during Republic Day flypast on 26 Jan. So, India has contracted 22 Apache helicopters and 15 Chinook helicopters from Boeing through foreign military sales program of the US government. So, the deal was, contract was done in 2015. It was under $3 billion deal. And out of 22 Apache, 17, and out of 15 Chinook, 10 have already been delivered. And now government also wants 6 additional Apaches for the army. And below you have PM and world leaders to attend Raisina dialogue. So at least 12 foreign ministers actually and 7 former heads of states and government will attend the Raisina dialogue, which is organized by External Affairs Ministry jointly with the Observer Research Foundation in Delhi. So the dialogue as such takes was also going to have Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison, but he has pulled out due to the fire crisis in Australia. So the title of the Raisina dialogue this year is Navigating the Alpha Century. So this is the 5th year of this Raisina dialogue. It hosts around 700 participants from more than 100 countries. And at least 40% of the speakers would be women, as also stated by the External Affairs Ministry. On international page, you have 5 countries to discuss action against Iran. So, 5 nations whose citizens died when an airliner was shot down by Iran will meet in London to discuss possible legal action. So, here you can see these 5 countries are including Iran and China actually. So, other countries were Sweden, Afghanistan. So, there were people from these countries too who were in the flight. So, they would all come together and talk on how action can be taken against Iran now on this mistake which it committed. It has called it a human error. And this is Mahinda Rajapaksa to visit New Delhi in February. So, this will be his first visit abroad after he has been appointed as Prime Minister. He was earlier President of Sri Lanka, presently is the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka. President is his brother. Gotabaya Rajapaksa, who has also visited India already after being sworn in. Then on business page you have government gets cracking on GST evaders with data analytics. So data analytics has been used. Official teams have booked 6,641 cases involving 7,164 entities till November 2019. And they have so far recovered about 1,057 crore rupees. So now GST implementation has been further made stringent. And this is antitrust probe ordered against Amazon Flipkart. So promotion of preferred sellers is alleged, and though India has clearly stated that they cannot have such provisions, still you can see that they are indulging in such preferred sellers as such. So practice. So India's antitrust body, which is the Competition Commission of India, has ordered an investigation into this alleged competition law violation by both Amazon and Walmart's Flipkart. Both are US-based e-commerce giants. So they were promoting some preferred sellers and in turn impacting the business of other smaller sellers. Then this is more time for firms to split MD-CEO posts. So, SEBI has extended the time for listed companies to separate the roles from April 1, 2020 to April 1, 2022. So, now they have 2 more years to split this position of CEO, Chief Executive Officer and Managing Director. So, this is the latest amendment by SEBI on SEBI regulations. So, SEBI has postponed the deadline for separation of this post of MD and CEO. It was SEBI Chairman Ajay Tiwari who had said that firms have been given sufficient time and seeking extension of deadline would only mean that companies do not want to comply. But now the extension has been given. Then below you have Railways invites RFQ, that is request for qualification document from private train operators. So Railways aims to create a huge to cater to a huge unmet demand. So it will select private parties to operate 150 passenger trains on 100 routes now. So, Ministry of Railways and Niti Aayog say that indicative cost of investment would be around 22,500 crore, which is sought through public-private partnership. So, on design, building, financing and operation. So, here you can see the ministry has regrouped, it has grouped the routes into 12 clusters. So, through PPP, they would be functioning with a concession period of 35 years. And a two-stage bidding process would be used for selection of bidders. First is request for qualification, and shortlisted applications will be eligible to take part in second stage, which is request for proposals. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.